Hello, my name is Bethany Stahl, and I'm a full-time self-published author and illustrator. If you are new to my channel, welcome. Here I post all things self-publishing, so if that interests you, make sure you subscribe. And if you are coming back, welcome. As you may know, I do have my self-publishing squad and workshop squad over on Patreon. If you are looking for more in-depth tips, tricks, and documents, contracts, behind-the-scenes videos, and so much more, Patreon is like the coolest. So if you are interested in getting even more information about self-publishing, head over there. And that is the best place where you can ask me questions. And I do see your messages over there immediately, which is great because I am able to respond to you and help you along with your journey. So if that interests you, head over there. And we even have once a month live workshops where we get together and tackle different topics in the publishing world. So it's a lot of fun. Go check it out. So today I'm going to be talking about how to price your book to make money. One of the biggest questions I get asked is, how do you know what to list your price at? And there's a bunch of different things you need to consider. The first is, you want to make sure your book is in the general range as other books in your genre. So you want your paperback to be priced similarly to other paperbacks, your hardcover to be priced for other hardcovers. If you're writing a novel, you do want your book to be priced the same as other novels. So look in your area of publishing and see what the prices are going for. Now, I know a lot of this confuses a lot of people, because prices on Amazon fluctuate a lot. So some of the things that can happen is Amazon can actually lower your price. So your price appears to be lower, but you make the same royalties. For example, my book Save the Ocean is frequently priced around $10.50, even though I have it listed at $12. What that means is it's cheaper for the customers and I still get all the same benefits. But Amazon knows that book is going to make money, so they are willing to take a cut on their end, which is really cool. But that can be misleading when you're looking for other books around your price. So a lot of my books, even though they're priced at $12 for my children's books paperbacks, they will appear as a bunch of other different prices on Amazon. So Amazon won't ever raise your price, but they can lower it, which is great for your customers. In addition to that, you also have to pay attention to traditionally published books. Traditionally published books are published overseas and are typically much, much, much cheaper than they are if you are using a print-on-demand company. Now, these books will be priced significantly lower than your books. But the perk with your books is you're not contributing to any sort of waste and you're not contributing to the environmental concerns that raises from shipping things overseas and all of labor differences and things of that sort. So it is something that you do have to be mindful of, that some books are going to be much cheaper depending on where they were printed and how they were made. But that doesn't mean that you should have to list your book cheaper. That just means that you are going to price your book competitively with other self-published authors. So check around in the self-publishing game what books are going for. You also want to consider, not only do you want to be in the same ballpark as everybody, but you need to make sure that you're making enough money to make a profit. So what you will get in terms of your cut from a company like Amazon or Ingram Spark does have to be enough to pay you and pay for any sort of other expenses you have, such as your illustrator, your editor, your formatter, even advertising, which is an expense that occurs throughout the lifetime of the book. So even though you may make a few dollars for every book, realistically, what's going in your pocket is going to be only a sliver of that, because you have to put that money towards other places as well. And you do want to make sure that you're able to afford to do this. Of course, we cannot keep publishing books if we are not able to support the cost of making that book. So once you figure out all of your expenses, you can then figure out where you would like your pricing to be. So for me, I price my paperbacks that I publish through KDP and Ingram Spark at $12 retail cost, and I do a 45% discount on Ingram Spark. And then I also price my hardcovers at $20 through Ingram Spark, and I do a 45% discount on that as well. Now, I used to recommend a 55% discount for Ingram Spark, but I have since switched to doing a 45% discount because what was happening is Amazon was ordering books from Ingram Spark and they were fulfilling their orders that way. However, the problem with that is they were getting a 55% discount. So I was actually getting paid less than I would be if Amazon just printed them themselves, which was really disappointing because I don't mind having a lower discount for bookstores, but I don't want to have a lower discount for Amazon to get around using their own printers. So I did make the price only a 45% discount. So if Amazon does want to do that in the future, they're going to be paying about 10 cents more than they would pay me if they printed them themselves. And I also really love the quality of KDP's printers. I think their quality is excellent in my opinion. I know there are differences of opinion, but I truly, truly, truly adore the quality that KDP has in terms of their colors. So I really do prefer my books to be printed through KDP than I do through Ingram Spark. Even though Ingram Spark is great and I'm not saying anything bad towards Ingram Spark, KDP is just on top of their printing game. And I do want to encourage Amazon to use their own printers because I much prefer the outcome of that. However, if you're not having Amazon order from Ingram Spark to fulfill those extra orders, what I would recommend is the 55% discount just because bookstores do prefer that a little bit more. When you factor in all those considerations, you will come to essentially how much you need from every book and then make sure you are paying yourself. So if this is something that you'd like to be a full-time career, you do want to be making money. The thing with books is it may seem like you don't make as much per book sold, but the beauty of books is that your income comes from when you sell a lot of books altogether. So even though you might not be making what you want per book, it really adds all up when you start to really accumulate your sales. And if you're not having that big of sales, make sure you check with your marketing tactics and get out there in your community to really spread the word about your books so you can start pulling in those bigger orders. I hope this video has helped. If it has, make sure you give this video a thumbs up and subscribe. And I will see you all next time. Happy publishing.
If you are looking for more information about publishing, go over to bethanystahl.com/classes to see a huge collection of information that I have gathered for you separated out into topics. Now, most of these classes are free to access, but there are a few that are exclusive to my self-pub patrons. If you do want to join that, go over to patreon.com/bethanystahl where you can join and get access to the classes as well as other behind-the-scenes tips, tricks, and documents that are exclusive to that squad. If you are trying to get into contact with me to ask questions, the best place to do that would be Patreon. I do see all of those messages and comments first, and I am able to reply to those almost immediately. So that is the best place for more individualized help. I hope this video has helped, and I will see you all next time.